The director of the Global Health Institute, Dr. Jonathan Patz, joins me now. Thank you so much for being here.
It's a pleasure, Dina.
I know you focus intensely on the environmental health effects of climate change, but also looking at solutions. So let's begin with the health effect of climate change.
Yes, climate change has many effects on health. There are many climate-sensitive diseases, climate-sensitive outcomes. There are so many pathways by which climate change affects health that I view it as the largest environmental public health crisis of our times. Think about heat waves, air pollution, photochemical smog, which is very temperature sensitive, insect-borne diseases like malaria, dengue fever, and also waterborne diseases. Because remember, climate change is not just about the mercury creeping up. It's also about extremes of the water cycle, more floods and more droughts. So that means waterborne diseases and contamination. And of course, our public health depends on adequate food and water resources. So the scenarios of climate impacts on crop yields is very significant and maybe one of the largest effects when you think about risk from malnutrition.
When you think about what a public health crisis this is, we need to find opportunities to kind of reduce these effects. And where do you think they lie?
Well, we need to think about the public health model of preparedness and prevention. And when we think about preparedness, for example, for a heat wave, imagine a heat wave that's so extreme, it's a 1 in 500 year event. That's going to become more frequent and more intense. And there have been studies that show that the European heat wave that was devastating in 2003, that already will increase by about tenfold. So that 1 in 500 year event becomes a 1 in 50 year event. So more extreme events, we need to be prepared for those. Likewise, with waterborne diseases and water crises, if you're a water manager and you're trying to keep drinking water safe, instead of preparing for the 50-year flood event, intense rainfall, that's going to become more frequent and more intense, and you're going to have to design those systems to be ready for more extreme climate variability.
So how now do you get this really critical message out about climate change and have it sort of reach all areas that are related to health?
Well, there's a simple message. Climate change risks are huge. Climate change health benefits could be enormous from climate change policies. So climate change policies to address greenhouse gas emissions could offer huge health benefits. Thinking about the cause of climate change, it's mostly burning fossil fuel. And WHO estimates that 8 million people die prematurely every year from indoor and outdoor air pollution. So if we were to get to a clean energy society, think how many lives would be saved from cleaner air, because when you burn fossil fuels, you create greenhouse gas emissions that cause climate change, but you also release criteria air pollutants like PM 2.5, ozone, and things like that that harm people. So if we have cleaner energy, we have an immediate benefit to health.
Well, so the message is really important, and I'm so glad that you're trying to get it out there because that's what we need.
Great. Thank you very much, Dina.